Be optimistic. When in the midst of sorrow, you can't see up when looking down. A brighter day tomorrow will bring. You hear the voice of reason telling you this cannot weigh me down. No matter how reality seems, just hold on to your dreams. Although it seems you'll never win, you will always pass the test. As long as you keep your head to the sky, you can win. 5 things to do during the Rona to help keep your sanity, plus the number one thing you must do every day. Are you tired of trying to do all the things? All you really want is to gain more energy and look better naked, or sometimes just not die walking up the stairs. Hi, I'm Dr. Letitia. I'm a physical therapist, run a nutrition coach that loves coffee, wine, and tacos. But my most important job is as wife and mother. I love helping others move, feel, and perform at their best without relying on pain meds or surgeries so that you can live your best life. The Get Fit Indie Show is for you if you believe fitness includes fueling your body and mind for life and wellness. Every week, we're going to deliver more natural ways to gain more energy, look and feel better naked, and have fun doing it. We love to support indie area local business, so highlighting healthier options, activities, and things to help you take action will be on tap as well. Have you or are you trying to find ways to live more naturally, or what about finding things to do in the indie area to help keep you active, mobile, and fit? Well, these are just 2 of the topics you'll find my guests and I discussing each week on the Get Fit Indie podcast show. Learn how to take action by making small changes in the way you eat, think, and move. Be sure to subscribe to the Get Fit Indie podcast and join the Get Fit Indie with Dr. Letitia Facebook group. Five things to do during the Rona to help keep your sanity. Plus, make sure you listen to the end for the number one thing you must do every day. So I'm reaching out to check on your mental and physical well-being during this time. I'm here for you. Scratch that. Let's be here for each other. So instead of focusing on the things we can't do or control, let's focus on the positive and make good use of our time. So let's start with number 5 in the 5 things you must do to maintain your sanity during the Rona. Number 5, stay away from foolishness. Okay, what does that mean? If there are toxic things or people around you, devise a plan to distance yourself from them. Now, this may be easy because of social distancing, or not so much because you have to interact with that person every day. I think reevaluating your life goals, determining what or whom adds to you and not subtracts, is something that now we may have more time to even think about, or more time because of us being more isolated and having to be in our homes to think about what are those things or people that are adding to me, not subtracting, or who are the people that are subtracting from me, that all they are the takers. They, you know, take, and you're doing all the giving. Obviously unbalanced there. So you may be thinking of someone or something, or like a bad habit, or you are so glued into every news report, you're becoming a hypochondriac. Pause, pray, breathe and release. Remember, according to my Apple Watch, even a minute of breathing can reduce stress. Now, how many of you guys have had that alert on their phone? Time for breathing, and you hit dismiss. I've done it numerous of times, but now I'm trying to be more conscious of utilizing that one breath, that minute of breathing. And yes, it is true. Deep breathing sends a message to your brain to relax and calm down. So that is also a way to stay away from foolishness. Don't be so absorbed in every single news article, every single report that's going on regarding COVID-19. Yes, be informed. Yes, get information required, but being sucked into every single news outlet and being consumed with it all day, every day long, or every single social media post or every single website or something that has written about it, it can really begin wear you down. Number four, don't be an island. If you isolate yourself so much that all you can see is work from home, e-learning with the kids, changing diaper, hubs at home too getting on my nerves, hours been cut from work, my business is shut down, eat, sleep, and do it all again, you will probably slowly begin to notice your mental health declining, or you may not even notice it. Your energy is low. You don't reach out to friends or family. All the fun has been sucked out of your life, and it's all you can do to make it through the day or week. You may even have a mental calendar of how many days it's been since you've been home, or how many days it's been since the kids been at home. I tell you what, with this e-learning with my fifth grader, it's definitely been a trial sometimes. And thankfully, I've been able to be at home to be able to assist him with some of those things. But yes, being able to go through this whole process of wishing he was still at school a full day and definitely be a challenge. But we continue to grind it out and do what we need to do. So the solution is, well, guess what? We all share some time on the struggle bus. I know I have. The key is to recognize it's okay not to be okay at all times. Find a confidant to talk to. Hop on a video chat. That's Hangout, or drop a text or call a friend for a self-care check-in. Find someone that can be your accountability, especially if you do live alone or it just may be you and children and all you can see right now is everything that's going on at home. Reach out, get that self-check-care in with a buddy. Number three, support a small business. The backbone of the United States, small business, without them, doomed. We really need our small businesses to continue to be open and thrive. A lot of them are taking hits. We don't know who will come out of this period of time and be able to actually make it. There will be, unfortunately, business that will not make it through the time. But what we can do now is order takeout, buy a product you would normally buy at a grocery store or other retail store, attend a virtual exercise class. We need them to survive, including myself as a small business as well. So I'm trying to be more conscious of being able to support others. We want to see as many as possible survive this and thrive. We know small businesses are taking a really big hit right now. So if you know small business owners and there's something that you can support them with, please definitely reach out and do that as well. Number two, search Eventbrite or Facebook events for new virtual slash online events to attend. That can be attending them. That could be sharing them to someone else. Here are some of the ideas that I've seen. Virtual Sip and Paint. That was actually an Eventbrite where basically you can go get the materials and then via video, the instructor takes you on how to virtually, obviously virtually paint, and then have your own beverage of choice. You know, you could go and do a Michael's pickup, you know, do an online order for Michael's or something similar. Go pick it up. You got your supplies. Now you have something else to do outside of just binge watch Netflix or or shows or something like that. So what we actually did, what prompted me on this was that I was searching for ideas for my sister's, older sister's birthday and just recently passed. And it's like, oh man, we won't be able to do, you know, margaritas. We won't be able to celebrate. So what can we do? It's also my nephew's birthday on the same day. What can we do to still hang out? So I start searching through Eventbrite and saw this virtual sip and paint. I was like, oh, well, maybe we can do something like that. Let me go ahead and see how much it costs. And then my husband was like, oh, you guys can do that yourself. I'm like, I'm not an artist. You know, I really do that just for fun. So he actually drew an image for us with the idea. And we found on, I think, Pinterest on how to trace, you know, using a plastic container and putting the image over and the light underneath it. And we could trace it or be able to print off the image and email it to all the rest of the ladies that were invited to it. So I told everybody, hey, we're going to hop on a Zoom call. This is a surprise. We're going to do this virtual sip and paint, bring the beverage of choice, and we're going to have fun and celebrate a birthday. Well, she loved the whole thing of coming together and surprised. Probably didn't like the drawing, the painting part as much because she said she does terrible. But hey, it was all in fun. And it was something else to do that we could still celebrate. Another activity that you can look up is something for kids. I saw there was a Lego activity class for those with boys or girls that love to build. That's very popular with my son. There's a gazillion Lego pieces in his room on the floor. And obviously, they're organized in his mind. But I hate trying to walk through the maze and not step on one of those things. Another event I saw was a free live cello kind of mini concert to start your day. There's a gentleman named Joshua McLean from Oakland, California. He's sharing his talents on Facebook live for free. And he also has a pay what you like option. So I saw that. I said, hey, I'm going to add that as an enrichment for my son to do and add it to like a yoga stretch time. Go ahead and search. And there's all types of activities that you can search out. Go to a concert or a party. Yes, the birthday party. There's DJs. There's people on Instagram. I know D Nice, I believe, is one that, hey, you can't go see them. They're going to come to you. So check out some of your favorite artists and see if they're doing Facebook Lives and offering some of their music. Something to take a look at. Also, there's online learning. So you want, go ahead and pick up a new skill or just expand your horizons and check out resources that are free to low cost. Go ahead and expanding your mind and being able to use time for all this time before that you didn't have enough time to do. Utilize it now, you know, try to think of this as more sometimes where you can say, hey, this is a blessing. I'm able to get these things down and not so much as it's just so bad. Yes, terrible what's going on, but utilize time how you can and also check on loved ones as well. So what is the number one thing you can do every day that you should be trying to do every day to help break, you know, not have you so crazy during the Rona, COVID-19, coronavirus, whatever you want to call it? The number one thing to do to help is walking. Yeah, you did not guess it probably. Okay, it sounds simple, doesn't it? But let's go ahead and break down walking and some of its benefits. It's low impact and low intensity. It can speed up recovery, decreasing stress in your joints and your central nervous system. So that means it can help with alleviating chronic stress. When you walk, you use your entire body and many muscles to walk. Everything is working together to move you forward. It helps manage local and whole body inflammation. So that means you will have better recovery and stress relief. Even short bouts of 10 to 15 minutes can boost overall wellness and get your creative juices going too. So why not work on that new idea for a business or whatever comes to mind during this time? So number one thing you can do every day, weather permitting, obviously, as well, or even if you have to walk around your house for 10, you know, different 5-minute bouts throughout the day of walking around your house. Hey, do what you have to do. Get out of your four walls when you can, get some fresh air and simply go for a walk. So my advice to you and your family, get to stepping. Hey, so until next time, make sure you check out Get Fit Indie podcast. Share with a friend. I really appreciate if you would subscribe and go ahead and leave a review. What are we going to talk about next week? Well, you have to find out. Make sure you subscribe and check out the Get Fit Indie podcast. Until next time. Yesterday is history. Tomorrow is a mystery. Today is a gift of God, which is why we call it the present. Bill King. Hey everyone, thanks for listening to the show. I know there are a million other things you could be doing and you probably were doing as you were listening. I got all the love for you. Check out the show notes to grab any tidbits or tools that were discussed today. Be sure to subscribe via Apple, Google, or whatever floats your fancy. You don't want to miss next week's show. Until next time, God bless, health is wealth, and remember, every day is a chance to live your best life.